जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय गोपी जाना बल्लाबा गिरिवर धारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरा बन चारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरा बन चारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे Thank you. सदगुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
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 नारायणं नमस्कृत्वा नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयम् उदीरयेत्। सुन्वतां स्वकथा कृष्णा पुण्यश्रावणकीर्तनः हृदयन्तोस्तो हि अभद्राणि विदुनति त्रुत्सतां नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया। भगवती उत्तमा श्लोके भक्तिर भवती नैष्टिकी। हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन। सो टुडे इट वाज नॉट प्लान्ड, यू नो, आई जस्ट पिक्ड अप, यू नो, और समवन सपोज टू गिव द क्लास टुडे, बट ड्यू टू सम रीजन Prabhuji did not join, so I'm just filling up. So let's pick up some verse and we'll discuss. So I'm thinking we'll discuss some pastimes of Govardhan, maybe. That works because the Govardhan, today we are celebrating a temple, the Govardhan Puja, and okay. All right, did you know which canto, which chapter? Tenth canto. Yeah, canto, I remember the chapter.
24 is worshipping God.
Okay.
25 is elect's God.
So we'll discuss some pastimes of Govardhan Leela. So 10th canto. Chapter Worshipping Govardhan Hill. So last time Pyare Prabhu discussed reading, right? Till what verse do you remember? Some 5 or 6, I believe.
At least 11, I think.
11, okay.
Yes, minimum 11, maybe.
Okay, let's start with the 12 then. Okay. You can see Sri Sukha. श्री शुक उवाच वाचो निशम्य नन्दस्य तथन येषां व्रजाशुकशम् इन्द्रया मनयुं जनयन् पितरं प्रह केशवः
पितरं प्रह केशवः
श्रीशुक उवाच
श्रीशुक उवाच
वाचो निशम्य नन्दस्य
वाचो निशम्य नन्दस्य
तथान्येषां व्रज व्रज उकशं
तथानेषां व्रजौकुशाम्
इन्द्रायामनयुं जनयान्
पितरं प्राह केशवः
श्रीशुक उवाच
वाचो निशम्यानन्दस्य
तथानेषां व्रजौकसम् इन्द्रायामनयुं जनयान्
पितरं प्राह केशवः
श्रीशुक उवाच
इन्द्रायामनयुं जनयान् पितरं प्राह केशवः श्रीशुक उवाच
वाचो निशम्य नन्दस्य
तथा येषां व्रजौकसम्
इन्द्रायामनयुं जनयान्
पितरं प्राह केशवः Would like to recite?
Sri Shuka Uvacha. Vacho Nishamya Nandasya. Tathayesham Vrajaukasham. Indrayamanayam Janayan.
पितरं प्राह केशवः
श्रीशुक उवाच
वचो निशम्य नन्दस्य
तथान्येषां व्रजौकसम्
इन्द्रायामनयुं जनयान् पितरं प्राह केशवः
So synonyms, Sri Shuka Uvacha, Sri Shukadev Goswami said.
Sri Shukadev Goswami said.
Vachaha, the words.
Nishamya, hearing.
Nandasya of Maharaj Nanda.
Tatha and also.
Anyesham of the others. Braja Okasham, the residence of Braja. Indraya, in Lord Indra. Manyum, anger. Janayan, generating. Pitaram to his father. Praha spoke. Keshavaha, Lord Keshava. Translation and purport. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Shukadeva Goswami said, when Lord Keshava Krishna heard the statement of his father Nanda and other senior residents of Braja, he addressed his father as follows to arouse anger in Lord Indra. Purport. Srila Sridhar Swami explains that Lord Krishna's intention was not simply to insult a demigod, but rather to knock down the great mountain of false pride that had arisen within the Lord's tiny servant, who was supposed to represent the Lord as Indra. By lifting a Govardhan hill, Lord Krishna would thus initiate a blissful annual festival called Govardhan Puja, and he would further enjoy the pleasant pastimes of dwelling for several days beneath the hill with all his loving devotees. Om Ajnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuran Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Namaom Vishnupadaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Tinamine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschatade Satarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadhadara Shivashadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare. So this pastime of Govardhan Leela, this is very sweet pastimes and one of my favorite pastimes. Also this pastime has so many learnings for us, especially the fallen souls. So everyone knows about this Leela, not to discuss much on this, but let's discuss what Srila Prabhupada is saying here. So basically what happens, if you go to the just previous verse, Nanda Maharaj was arranging for Govardhan, for Indra Puja, you know, because every year in the Gokula, right, where Nanda Maharaj resides, and he arranged this demigod sacrifice. So they offer different foodstuff and yajna to Indra so that the rain comes and they can have the better production of their grains and other foodstuff. But when Krishna, I think at that time he was how old, maybe 7 or very little. And he saw that all the Brajavasis, they are arranging for this yajnas and food sacrifice. They cooked so many foodstuff and they're offering to Indra. And when Krishna saw that, and definitely that is not the right way to perform yajna, right? In a demigod worship, exactly in, we know, and Krishna also in Bhagavad Gita very explicitly mentioned in the 7th chapter, and I think we are discussing that same chapter in the evening classes. So what is the position of demigods, right? Demigods, they are the representative of Krishna. They are also devotees of Krishna, and they are engaged in the various services, and they are taking care of different material affairs. They are, so one should approach the Supreme Lord Krishna directly instead of approaching the demigods. Although Krishna mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, you know, Krishna gives the power to demigods. And the demigod, why Krishna gives the power to demigods? So that, because whoever the devotees of demigod, they can stick to their devotion, at least, you know, living like an animal, you know, not following any right path, and at least they'll have a little faith in the demigods, and eventually they will come to the Krishna. That's what Krishna mentions, that I give them power so that the demigods devotees can stick to that worship. But then Krishna mentioned that those who are approaching demigods, they are doing abadi purvakam, means they are approaching demigods wrongly, not right way of doing worship. And even if they have a material requirement, they can still approach Krishna. That's what Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita. So here, Krishna wants to teach this knowledge or give this information to all the Brajavasis. And there is a discussion between Nanda Maharaj and Krishna. And there is Krishna asks, you know, Father, Baba, why are you offering all this foodstuff to Indra? And Nanda Maharaj say that, you know, this is the ritual that every year they perform, and this is has to be done, otherwise they won't get rain. Then Krishna starts explaining, no, you know, Indra is a not a source of everything, you know. Indra is getting the power from some, is a supreme lord, you know, not from himself, you know. Instead, you can offer all, you know, foodstuff and yajna to Govardhan, you know, because Govardhan is what is giving the foodstuff. You know, every day, every morning, our cow go there and eat grass, you know, and we also get so many fruits and everything. In fact, Govardhan is covered by so many forests at that time, right? Not only just Govardhan. So let's, why don't you offer that, you know, that makes sense, you know. That's what it happened, the conversation. Then when all the Brajavasis started offering yajnas and fruit stuff to Govardhan, Indra got anger, you know. He said that, what, who is that boy, you know, who is you know, misleading these Brajavasis, huh? How dare he to do this, you know. Then he sends all his Samartaka or all to pour torrent of rains and to punish the Brajavasis. And then the pastimes happened, you know, it was continuously rained for I think 7 days, and Krishna lifted Govardhan, and under the Govardhan, and all the Brajavasis took shelter. Not only the Brajavasis, even cows, whatever, all the animals, you know, everyone took shelter of that. So this is a famous thing, right? We are talking about a lockdown, right? When the corona was going on, everyone is literally locked down at home. And at that time, we see that the Brajavasis locked down for 7 days under the hill. But only difference is that they have a Krishna with him. And, you know, there's a pastime. So here, Prabhupada is saying the pride, right? The pride, the talking about the pride. So what is that pride? If you think that, you know, Indra, all the demigods, even Brahma got bewildered. So how is it possible? You know, is that they're not aware of Krishna? Or what is the reason for that? You know, they're aware of Krishna. They know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But this is what happens, right? When we come in contact with the material world, real constitutional position will be lost. Like, we forget about Krishna. We are actually part and parcel of Krishna, but due to association of with this material world, our real identity will be lost. And this, because of Krishna's external energy, we got bewildered, and what happens, we forget about Krishna, and then take association of all this material things. So that is what the cause of all forgetfulness. And also slowly we completely forget Krishna, and that's where the real misery starts. So whatever the problems we see in this material world, you know, that if you think about root cause, is the root cause is forgetful of Krishna. That only, and the bhakti process says how to remember Krishna. So from forgetful to remember Krishna, that is the solution of everything. And that is also bhakti called. And bhakti defines a different process. And end of all the process, the result is remembering Krishna. And if we are daily, we are discussing the second canto. where Parikshit Maharaj and Sukadev Goswami is discussing, and Parikshit Maharaj asks the same question. You know, Parikshit Maharaj has the 7 days. So what should I do? 7 days I have in my life. What is the, tell me, the ultimate good for human society, human beings, especially those who are dying. So Parikshit Maharaj has 7 days. And if you think about that, every one of us is in the same situation. Everyone is dying, right? Only the difference is the time factor, right? Parikshit Maharaj is dying in 7 days. We may die in the next 30 years maybe. For myself, I'm saying, or 20 years, or 10 years, we don't know. Or next moment, right? So everyone is this condition. That's why Sukadev Goswami said that you have asked the right question and it's applicable for everyone. So that is the situation. So everyone is suffering, you know, everyone is dying. And we are talking about this pride. So what happens when we get success, right? When we are associated with this material world, and material world is nothing but it's Krishna's energy only, and Krishna's external energy. It's a manifestation of Krishna's external energy, and we are also the Krishna's energy. We are the marginal energy. We are little superior than Krishna's material energy. Because of that little superiority, we are trying to control over there, and we cannot control, but we are getting that. And that endeavor, what happens? We get success, and we think that we are the superior than any. That's what the pride develops. You know, I am the doer. That comes. That is called false ego. Also, the real identity, that's not real identity, the false ego. Because of that, we develop that pride. The I am the doer. Karta aham iti manyate. Krishna says, ahankara vimudhatma karta aham iti manyate. Means ahankara, because of the false ego, this living entity thinks that I am the doer, I am the creator, I have the power. And Indra is also thinking that, you know, I am the source of I am the source. Because of me, the Brajavasi is getting food. So why they should worship me? Then why they are not worshipping me? So that is the pride. You know, he developed. He knew, Indra also know that Krishna is a superior, but and how to get rid of this pride, how to kill this pride, that is more important for us, right? You know, as long as we have taken birth in this material world, definitely this anarthas will be there. You know, all the, not only pride, we have a envy, we have a anger, we develop illusion, you know, false ego, pride, illusion, greed, you know, lust, right? These all are common byproduct of this material world. You know, no one can say that I am free from all these things. So that is the process, you know, that is the process we need to, how to get rid of the pride. So when we discuss the root of this pride, I told that it's because of our false identity. We are identifying with our body. We are thinking that we are the creator. But when we understand that we are not the creator, Krishna is the Supreme Lord who is the creator. And even we are also controlled by Krishna. We are also marginal energy. And nothing is possible with the Krishna's will. And when we understand this, then our prideness will go, right? That is the one thing. Now again, right? How to understand that Krishna superiority? Again, if you again go a little down, right? Because everyone in this world, there are so many living entities, but very few people are also coming to this conclusion that Krishna is the supreme Lord, and we have to surrender to Krishna and follow the instruction of Krishna. So that is the process of our anartha nibriti process, right? And if you see, the anartha nibriti comes before that, it's a bhajana kriya. So that is the only option. There is not no rocket science we have, or no tools, or nothing is our, only is that bhajana kriya. You know, bhajana kriya means chanting and listening, reading Krishna katha, hearing more. That is only the bhajana kriya. Before bhajana kriya, it starts the association of the devotees. sadhu sangha. Sadhu sangha and bhajana kriya, this has to be run parallelly. That is the only formula we have. There is nothing else. You know, the more you associate with the devotee and more involved in the chanting process, hearing process. You know, this is the Shravanam and Kirtanam. This is the most important process which we have to do. You know, and if you continuously do, then what happens? Slowly, you know, the covering which you have in your heart, the impurities which we have, that will be slowly removed. You know, that is called Marjana, the washing, right? That is what the process. You know, the more we understand about Krishna and more we hear about Krishna. That is what the process, and that's what we understand. For example, if you hear about someone regularly, Krishna's greatness and Krishna's sweetness. When we understand the Krishna's greatness, then we understand, right? Then we feel that, okay, really there is a process of surrender, right? So if someone, if you want to know about President of America, then we should know about that position, the greatness of that position, right? Then only we can understand that. Otherwise, if simply say he's the president of understand, but we don't know who is president, what is his roles, and how he get that position, then okay, it's a simple person. That's why it is recommended that we should understand the greatness of Krishna, then come to the sweetness of Krishna. That's why Prabhupada always says that, you know, do not jump into 10th canto directly. Because if you jump into 10th canto directly, then we do not understand the sweetness of Krishna. We will misunderstand the sweetness of Krishna. But when you read Bhagavad Gita and all the chapters, then we understand the greatness of Krishna. Then we can say that when Krishna performs all the Leela, yeah, he can do that. He is the Supreme Lord. So coming back to the pride, right, that is what, when we understand Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya, Nityam, this reading Srimad Bhagavatam, hearing and associating with the devotee, chanting and performing the service, you know, that is the only process which we have, which can, help us to come out of this pride, you know, lust, envies, all this process. This is a process which is practical process, which our Acharya also mentioned. There could be some another, if some very elevated soul, they can get direct mercy from someone, you know, they can directly jump into that page. But in general, for all of us, you know, we have to develop this attitude of reading, hearing and chanting. That is the only process. That is the only process which cleanses our heart. And when the heart is cleansed, all the anarth is gone. Then we will be situated in our real situation. Then we don't get pride. You know, we don't get envy. You do not get developed lust. So here in this chapter, what's happening? Krishna to teach lesson to Indra. So he did this act. So by lifting Govardhan hill, Lord Krishna was, so what happened? Lord Krishna's intention was not simply to insult the demigod, but rather to knock down the great mountain of false pride that had arisen within the Lord's tiny servant. To break down that false ego, Krishna performed this great Govardhan, right? So basically, he could have directly punished Indra, but he didn't do that. Krishna wanted to see, let's see how extent Indra can go. You know, that way only he can break his pride, right? Yeah. Otherwise, who is Indra? At the first day only, he would have punished Indra so that no rain. But Krishna didn't do that. Let him use all his power, and I will show my power. That's why he lifted and stayed for 7 days. Then finally, you know, Indra has to come down. You know, he has to say that who is definitely, it's the Supreme Lord who can do this. Otherwise, no one has that power who can, you know, stand before Indra. That's right. Same thing happened with our Brahma also. Brahma also, he also got pride, and he Brahma stolen all his cowherd friends and monkeys and everyone, right? And he kept there. And he, Krishna could have done same thing, you know. He would have gone there, Brahma, and punished and bring them back. No, he stayed for 1 year, and he manifested 10,000 folds, and he become like his friends and like that, you know. And 1 year, then Brahma is thinking, oh, who is this guy? How come it's possible? I've stolen everyone, but no one is inside. Everyone is living their original life. Then he understood. And then what happened? Okay, let his pride, you know, to break his pride, he invited all the Brahmas, millions of Brahmas. So came there. Then he saw that, who? He was thinking, I am the only Brahma. I am the only the Brahma, and I am the Lord. I see so many Brahmas. Then his pride also gone. You know, that is what, you know, Krishna teaches lesson. And in our life also, you know, if you truly surrender, you know, sometimes Krishna comes in our way to give a punish us, you know, to give. Because, you know, Bhagavatam also says, right, you know, many episode we know that, you know, even in case of devotees, you know, they see some miseries in their life. And we may think that, why? You know, Krishna says that, you know, Kaunteya pratijanai name bhaktya pranishyati. You know, Krishna says that, you know, my devotees never perishes, never feel. But on the other side, we see that Krishna and devotees also getting some kind of miseries in their life, you know. But why it happens? And it's very important point we have to understand here, that devotees, when we say devotees, they're surrender, purely surrender devotees. You know, for them, Krishna interfere in Krishna, because this matter, Maya, is so strong. You know, and sometimes devotees cannot get rid of that Maya. Devi hi esa gunamai mama maya durattaya. Mayam mama eva yaptarte mayam etam tarantita. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita 7.14, says that this material energy, this Maya, is very strong. It's very difficult to overcome. But those who surrender to me, they can easily overcome. So this Maya is so difficult, and sometimes our endeavor is very difficult, and Krishna helps them, you know. And sometimes he gives. Sometimes we are so much attached with something, we're trying to come out of that, we are not able to do that. Although we are chanting and doing that, and Krishna sees our sincerity, then Krishna will interfere and take away that. So those kind of miseries also we see that. But remember, it's very rare. We should not think that, oh, every misery you are seeing, oh, it's a Krishna's hand. But it's not also that Krishna will give punish to everyone. It's not that. You know, sometimes people think that, oh, this is a very very common understanding that, you know, I have heard also, they do not approach Krishna because they have an understanding that when approach Krishna or when surrender to Krishna, Krishna will give problem to us. That is also not true. You know, it's not. If we are truly surrendered, and Krishna gives the, it's not a problem. Krishna is trying to help us to come to closer to him. He's taking away that impediments. What is the impediment? That attachment. You know, so Krishna is taking out that attachment. I think that's all I would like to say. If anyone would like to add anything or have any question. Yes, Mataji.
We are not able to hear Prabhu, sir.
Okay. They can't hear you. I think we need to put mic. Yeah, Mataji is saying about
Krishna fulfills multiple purposes at one time.
Yeah.
Brahma Leela as well, when Brahma stole all the cowherd boys. But at that time, the Vrajavasis were thinking that they should, all the young cowherd boys should get married because they are at the right age. But then Brahma stole all the cowherd boys. So Krishna expanded in himself and then married all the gopis. So in one Leela, he also fulfilled desires of gopis and Brahma could do his Leela as well. So Krishna is multi-purpose.
They didn't have anything.
And before that, Maladeva said that in essence that Govardhan is also like Haridas Varya, one of the greatest devotees. So in the time of the need, Brajabhashis took shelter of Krishna and his greatest devotees. So in our lives as well, if we take shelter of Krishna and his pure devotees, there is no impediments. So we can shelter of Srila Prabhupada, his acharya, his pure devotee, there is no impediments.
Yeah, this Leela is, in fact, all the Leelas as, I would say that every chapter I'm reading Bhagavatam, it gives the lesson as lesson to us, some lesson, you know, and all are applicable to us. And that's why I always think why Acharya says that, you know, reading Bhagavatam every day is important. Because every lesson we learn that, you know, our condition and we'll come out of that conditions. It's very helpful and it's very... Yes. Very, very interesting, you know, everyone should read Bhagavatam or join 7 a.m. every day. We are trying to read, you know, at least one verse or that's it. Every day?
Yeah,
eventually we can do that, Mataji. That's the plan. You know, we can have a 7 a.m. But yeah, Gita Mala Mataji is pinging that Saturday, Niranjan Maharaj also gives class in the morning. Yeah. I think 7 or 7:15.
7:15, okay. So when the class was at 8, it was good for me. At least I could join part of the class.
Yeah. So what's Mataji... you know, since we opened our temple, so the timing has changed because it's a part of our daily the aarti and Mangala aarti and puja. So that's why it's changed.
But in most temples, isn't it like 7 o'clock is greet the deities and the classes afterwards, right?
Yeah.
What did she say?
Mata is saying that it's, you know, we can listen Niranjan Maharaj also in the Saturday if he is giving every Saturday.
Yeah, most Saturdays he's giving. Today he cancelled. So, but I didn't realize our class started at 7.
I've heard false ego and real ego. So here it says false pride. So is there like a real pride? If it is, what is a real pride? If there is, I don't know. That's why I'm asking.
Real pride. I mean, again, I can just add my version, you know, what I thinking. Yeah. Pride means, you know, we have something which is great. And we think that we get a pride of we did this, right? So sometimes I mean, what real pride means, if you do some service, what I'm thinking, like for example, but again, the pride itself is negative, right? Pride means a real pride means if you do some service or something, then if you get that little pride, that may be the real pride. But again, that also it has a negativity, right? Yes, because right. Even if you're doing the service, even if you get the pride, right, that also leads to, you know, negative.
That's where my confusion is. I mean, I'm just trying to understand. I'm not trying to put you on the spot. False ego and ego, it's easy to understand. But here it says false pride. So that's why I just wanted, because I had the same thought while I was meditating. That, okay, pride also is not good in a way. So.
False pride is proud of yourself. Real pride, proud of Krishna. Proud that I have such a wonderful spirit. Proud that I'm part of this elevation of some higher.
So also we know that, right, we have all the six anarthas, and six anarthas can be utilized in the service of Krishna. So that could be the one thing, right? Even if you get anger, you know, anger for yourself is not right, but you can develop the anger when some devotees are tortured, you know, like Hanuman, right? He has an anger. So what he did, he used the anger and put the fire in the Lanka. So he used his anger for the service of the Lord. So that, so every anartha has a thing, right? I mean, we cannot, sometimes we cannot get rid of complete zero this anarthas. It will come, but if you use for the right cause, that it won't be treated as anartha. So as Mataji said, so if for everyone, right? Mataji said that pride, you know, pride for ourselves is not good, but when we can get pride that we are part of Vaishnavas, we have a Krishna, we took a shelter of Krishna, we have a devotee surrounded by devotees, and we have a nice prasadam every Sunday, or now every week, every day we are getting in the evening. So we should be proud of that, you know, that's what we can do. That may be the real pride.
You have to repeat what Mataji says, because we cannot hear her.
So repeat.
So Krishna can destroy the pride. So Mother Jiva gave two examples. One is Sudarshan Chakra. No, it has a potency that basically it can destroy all our anarthas. And second one,
Narsingadev.
Lord Narsingadev, as he we can, there are prayers in the Shastras, and we can offer prayer that, you know, remove the obstacles in terms of anarthas, and he can do that. So those were the two examples Mataji was cited for benefit of the devotees.
And that we can be proud that Krishna destroyed our false pride.
And we can be proud that Krishna has all the ability in the world to destroy our false pride.
Okay, I think it's 8 o'clock. We'll start the Guru Puja now. Thank you, everyone. Vancha Kalpataru Viksha Kripa Sindhu Vaivacha Patitanam Pavanevo Vaishnavendra. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai. So just stay online. We'll be doing Guru Puja now.
Guru Karuna Sindhu Adhava Jantara Bandhu Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama
His Divine Grace Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai Ananda Kota Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Jai Ramacharya Srila Haridas Thakur Ki Jai Frames Go Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Srila Sri Gaura Bhaktam Ki Jai Sri Sri Radha Krishna Gopa Gopinath Shamakur Narakur Giri Govardhan Ki Jai Sri Braja Bhumi Vrindavan Dham Ki Jai Navadvip Mayapur Dham Ki Jai, Purushottam Kshetra Jagannath Puri Dham Ki Jai, Gangamai Ki Jai, Jamunamai Ki Jai, Bhakti Devi Ki Jai, Srimati Tulsi Maharani Ki Jai, Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai, Harinam Sankirtan Ki Jai, Brihat Madanga Transcendental Book Distribution Ki Jai, Sri Rupchi Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiva Gopala Bhatta Dasa Raghunath, Sadhguru Swami Prabhu Ki Jai, Nidai Goa Premananda, All glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, Kartik Mas Damodar Vrata Ki
Jai
Govardhan Ki
Jai.
Hare Krishna, thank you for joining. We are closing our Saturday morning line.